Hey guys, so I know you're probably wondering, why is this guy sitting there with the piggy bank and a rock? Well, truth is, the piggy bank's full of money, and the rock is because I don't have any hammers. So, what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and improvise in order so we can go ahead and make this video lock. I guess a lot of questions that I keep on getting asked is, how do I save money? How do I invest in something that's going to bring me profit? Okay, so I think what's really important is knowing how to practice patience. Being able to practice patience and setting your money aside is really, really important. A lot of us, we live paycheck to paycheck, and I know that it's really, really hard to go ahead and set aside $20. You know, so, I mean, what you can possibly do to help out and kind of sort of save a little bit more money is to go ahead and set aside maybe $5. Anything less, whatever change that you have, the same thing. Go ahead and get it and put it into something like this, a piggy bank. Maybe you don't have, you know, about, I think this is like $15 at Target, enough money. And why would you be like, why am I going to buy a piggy bank if I'm trying to save money? Well, then get a shoebox. You know, get a shoebox in your mom's closet. Get somewhere where you can put your money and keep it safe. The whole purpose is basically is to put your money so that you can't see it physically. You know, you don't want to have to see your money, because you're going to see it, you're going to be like, oh snap, I want to, you know, put it in my pocket and go and buy something. Or you're going to think in your head, well, you know what, I know how much money I have, and I've been wanting that iWatch for a while, so why not go get it? No. What you want to do is you want to set aside your money so that you don't see it, you stuff it in somewhere, and it stays there, and it stays hidden away from you. So obviously whenever you see a lot of movies, you see a lot of people get their shoe boxes and they put it up in their closet, or they pull it out from under their bed and they stick money inside there and, you know, close it back up. That's kind of sort of the exact same concept that you want to do. A piggy bank, the only cool thing about it is that it looks great, you know, and then it's also fun to break. Get yourself a box, fill it up with tape, cut a hole on the top of it, put whatever change you got, whatever dollars you got in there, and go ahead and put it in somewhere that only you know where it's at, okay? At the end of each year, what you do is you're going to go ahead and crack open that box, and I want you to get that money and go and either put it into the bank, into your savings account, or you can get that money and you can invest it into something that you know that you want, something that's going to help you out. Photographers, in your case, it would be you invest that money into buying yourself that camera, so that way you can further your progress of your work. You might want to buy yourself that lens that you need. If you're a videographer, then you would maybe do the same thing. You maybe buy yourself your light gear, maybe something that looks more professional, business cards, maybe get yourself a shirt with your logo on there, maybe start your website, clothing companies. Maybe you want to go ahead and start investing into your logo, getting your designs and your prints made, you know, things like that. That's what's going to start you to start going into the right direction. It's just all you need is just a few $100s. But in an entire year, if you're saving, you know, $5 here, you know, $10 there, maybe $20 you can spare it and put it in there where you don't want to touch it anymore, it's going to help out in the long run. In this case, what I'll be doing is I'll be cracking into my piggy bank. I want to know how much money I've saved in here, you know, because something is better than nothing, right? Anyways, okay, let's go ahead and get repositioned so we can go ahead and start this portion. I know you guys are curious how much money is in here, and I'm actually kind of curious as well. So let's see what happens. And this thing has the cutest little tail ever, right there. So if I can keep anything, I'm going to keep this right here. Okay, so first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna go ahead and clear off this entire counter. Why? Because, look at this, woo! I feel like I can just pull it off of this, huh? Because I need the space in order for me to go ahead and break this apart without having any issues. So, we got a clean counter. We're gonna put you right here because you're a good guy. We're definitely gonna enjoy doing this. Oh, this is really gonna suck. Oh man, are y'all ready for this? Look at this, beautiful rock. Poor little piggy, you shall meet your demise. Here we go. 1, 2, 3. Look at that. That is amazing. Look at all the money. Now the goal is to go ahead and count it all. That is ridiculous. Look at that. Yeah, can't wait for this. Tell you the truth, I made a huge mess. Bentley actually got pretty scared, huh, Bentley? Look at this.
I'm gonna... What's the matter, dude? Huh? You weren't having it, were you? Nope. Not having it. What I'm kind of confused about is, how do you have your leg up so high? Okay, so what we're gonna do now is we're gonna go ahead and go through this entire thing and see how much money is actually in there. We can give it some little close-ups and stuff so you can peek out how much money. And we got a 50 right here. I see a 10 in there. I see, I know you can hear me stepping on piggy bank pieces. Oh, oh. There's 100 right here. There you go. 20. So let's go ahead and get this count started and then we'll go from there. Okay, I would definitely not want to work at a bank. This is some rigorous work. Let's go ahead and see if we can get this money sorted out. Still haven't counted everything. Just laying everything out so I can know where I'm at. There it is, completely counted and assorted into little categories. So there it is, I went ahead and counted all the money, I sorted it out, put it into little groups, and I even labeled it. Even labeled it so that way I can go ahead and when I go make a deposit and change it into cash, smaller bills, so I'm not carrying all of this to France. I don't have any issues when I'm going through customs and shit like that. So. $1,309 cash is what I had, and then a total within the coins ended up being $1,364.68. That's a lot of money. That's a lot of money because it's just money that's been sitting there that I've been setting aside from my pockets, from out of my wallet that I just had spare change. So there's a lot you can do with $1,364. You can buy a lot of stuff. A lot of stuff to go ahead and further your career, or go ahead and get yourself a new place. That's like a deposit on a new apartment, you know? So making the right choices with the money that you have is what really matters. You have to learn how to go ahead and restrict yourself from buying things that you don't need. This money right here, I'm gonna go ahead and put it to use, or I can just go ahead and leave it in my bank account and not even worry about it, and go ahead and let it accumulate, you know, within my savings. But it's definitely something that you need to try out. I know it may be hard at first, but you got to go ahead and start somewhere. Just imagine it this way. If you put a dollar away every single day for the rest of the year, and then at the end of the year and get that, put that together, you know, that's more than what you had at the beginning of the year. So go ahead and subscribe. I appreciate you guys watching the video. If you guys have any questions, don't hesitate to comment below. If you guys need anything else and we'd like us to cover some certain topics that you'd like us to discuss, feel more than free to go ahead and let us know. Teresa will be in our next video next time for a video blog. Thanks for being here and go ahead and enjoy. Bye, guys.